The party's here on the west side. 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 Oh, it's party time.
This just in, breaking news from River Bluff High School. Several staff members and District 1 employees, and Rick Henry from WIS-TV News, have been arrested. No further details are known at this time. They are all currently behind bars. We plan on giving you more information as we get it in this episode of Gator Gossip.
Welcome back to Gator Gossip.
Gator Gossip, rated 5 stars by this guy right here.
Let me out!
He wants to tell you
out. He wants to get out.
He wants to show that. So.
You may be asking yourself, what's going on here at River Bluff? Well, these guys behind us have done something bad, Jack.
We put him
in jail for something bad. We're just kidding. Coach Bonnet's crew is doing a fundraiser for bailing for Baldrick's by putting people in jail, and they have to raise money to get out.
Yeah. It's really great what they're doing over here. I'm so proud of them. Impact conferences are going great. Seniors keep working hard.
Yeah, bailing for Baldrick's, but there also is balding for Baldrick's, as students today are shaving their heads to raise money. Upcoming, the Optera Solutions Baseball Tournament will be running March 2nd to March 5th with Home Run Derby Saturday night at 6:30. All games will stream on Gator Game Day.
Nice.
So if you can't watch it or go to the stadium, you can't watch it on Gator Game Day. It's a some games will be going on during school.
Yeah, that's
so
true.
If your teacher's okay with it, maybe stream it while class is going on.
There's literally no reason you should not be able to watch it at this point. It's just so accessible now.
It's so nice. With YouTube, everything streamed, and we're so excited.
Boys and girls soccer, great job last week in the Capital City and Viking Cup. Season's looking good. Go ahead, guys.
Soccer teams are doing great this year. Excuse me?
I'm innocent! Jack! There was a traffic stop gone bad. I need better representation.
We got guys.
We have raised, it's been 10 minutes, we have raised $500.
And 23 cents.
I mean, it's gone on for 10 minutes. We got people shaving their heads over here, and this is awesome.
Someone just donated $25.55.
Well, this is what's going on today at River Bluff High School. Your school is not better than our school. How many people don't get put in jail in your school?
Yeah.
We're so excited.
It's crazy.
We're going to continue this all crew long.
Hey, there are my friends over there. Hey, come here.
Come on over.
Come on. These guys were in once upon a matches last week. Hey,
Wyatt, come back.
How did once upon a matches influence you as a person?
It was a great show. A whole lot of stuff happened. It was all great. It made me a better person.
That's great to hear.
That's awesome.
You know, my role just taught me a lot about having to listen more than actually say.
It's great to hear.
Court, you didn't get to talk much during the show. You were muted. You're live here on Gator Gossip. What do you want to say?
What do I want to say? Well, Connor, I'm very glad that you asked me that. Really, what I want to say.
It's beautiful.
That was beautiful, Court. Thank you guys so much. Once upon a mattress, the stars of the show, Wyatt Pittman, Court Stevenson, live here in the Rotunda.
It's awesome.
Gator Gossip, bailing for Baldrick. We got former principal Dr. Clamp here. Dr. Clamp, what did you do?
Connor, first of all, I'm innocent. The accusation, it was a traffic stop. It went bad.
He caused a 12-car pileup.
Dr. Clamp, how much money have you raised today?
We're a little under our goal right now. We're in about $50. We need more. Everybody out there, we need more, Connor.
Need more.
Let him free. Mr. Smith.
Yes.
We're live here on Gator Gossip.
We just
want to know what you did to get in jail.
Well, I can't disclose that information. Attorney privilege. But you can ask my attorney. Gotcha. What do you plead?
I am his attorney, and we cannot talk
go
about
Gators!
It.
Go Gators.
Mr. Smith, how much money have you raised today?
This at least $3,000.
$3,000. We're live on Gator Gossip.
Where do I look?
Huh? At the cameras right there. How are you doing today?
I'm good. I just sat behind for the SAT prep, but I'm taking the ACT.
Oh, yeah. Pre-cutting session is on the 28th. Tomorrow. Yeah. It's going to be awesome.
Ella, what are you most excited about this year, 2023 Riverball soccer season?
I'm ready to beat Lexington.
Beat Lexington!
How many times?
Twice.
Okay, and if you beat them in the playoffs, by chance, would you beat them again?
Yes.
That's great to hear. Future of our program. And who?
Wando.
Why is that?
Because we're better than them.
Yeah, that's exactly why. Because we're here to beat every single team in front of us. Ella, thank you so much for joining us.
Bye, Jack.
Bye.
We've got a special guest here.
Oh, the bear
he's tripping over equipment.
The bear is back.
He's tripping over. Hodges, you filmed your Gator gossip in the fall for, and you were bare picking teams.
Oh.
This week, we've got a huge baseball tournament at River Bluff High School. What are you most excited about?
You know, I'm excited to get to see some good competition, some good guys. Got to get some good teams coming here.
Oh.
Somerville, Southside Christian, and I believe Wren. You know, it'll be a good test for us. Good to see some good guys before region play really gets started.
I just were so excited to see the baseball team here. Thank you so much for coming back on.
Hey.
Anything else you'd like to say?
Hey, go Gators.
Go Gators.
Come on in here, guys.
We've got Sentinel Knobs here. Maddie Garris and Preston Sutton. No, they are balding for Baldrick. What does this new haircut feel like?
I just got drafted. So, I feel like I'm about to go do some work over there, boys, for USA.
Yes, sir. Hey, Preston, come on. How does the new haircut feel?
Very light, very breezy. I love it, man.
Love it. Thank you guys so much for donating money coming
right,
on
right.
this show.
Boy. Yes, sir. No problem.
$1,000. Somebody just cut a check.
Yeah, that was me.
I donated that money, guys.
$1,000. Right. Whoever
Coach,
that is, thank you so much.
Coach Deere, how are you doing today?
Doing well. A little tired, but I think I'll be all right.
Nice. What sports do you coach?
Men's soccer.
Men's soccer. All right. Who is one player on the team that you would not let date your daughter if you had one?
Any of them.
Any of them. More specifically, if you had to choose one.
Had to choose one? Oh, and Deer.
Thank you. Coach Bonnet, welcome.
The leader behind this whole process that we're having today in the crew. Coach Bonnet, just tell me a little bit about what led y'all's crew to do this and what you've seen the impact that it's done.
Well, for us, you know, coming up with an impact, with a topic for our impact conference, we were talking as a class, had different ideas, and, you know, we kind of talked about how one of our current baseball players, Braden Sox, was diagnosed at 10 years old with leukemia.
Right.
And we lived it, as our baseball program lived it. So when they came in and spoke to our crew's like, that's going to be our topic. That's what we want to do. So this idea of the bailing for Baldrick's, really, I stole it from my wife. Over at Lexington High School, the SIA Club, they do this annually. Yeah. We're wanting to do this annually now at River Bluff.
That's
and
awesome.
We're already right now over $2,000 raised, awesome. And we've been going for 30 minutes.
Well, thank you so much, Coach
awesome.
Bonnet, and your leadership in this crew and on the baseball field. You got a big tournament coming up this week. What are you most excited about?
Seeing my guys play, our guys play. You know, just we're tired of practicing against each other, inter-squatting. We're playing a really good competition. You know, obviously our season, the tournament doesn't make or break our season, but the competition we're playing, it gives us a test early to see where we're at.
Thank you so much,
hey,
Coach, for coming up.
Since I'm a junior this year, I'll shave my head next year. I got you. Remember.
Y'all about to be in jail next.
Oh, yeah, I know.
Jack and Connor were arrested that day. Some say it was because Connor's voice was too loud, which may have been a microphone issue. Others say it was because Jack tried to date Coach Deer's daughter. Whatever the case, they joined several other students who were arrested as well. Perhaps it was all just bad luck, I guess.
Friday and Saturday, 64 teams will compete in the state finals of VEX Robotics. See Team Swampbots destroy the competition with their powerhouse, the Howitzer. Also watch as Team Gator Gears use Bionic Reptile to chew up their opponents and spit them out. Come to River Bluff this weekend and witness all the exciting robot action. winners get a chance to go to the VEX World Finals. You don't want to miss the VEX Robotics State Finals, only at River Bluff High School. Be there.
Please.
Help!
Please get me out of jail. These people are maniacs. These people are maniacs.
I've raised $3.
Oh my God.
Help me.
We got the SAT.
Yes! I'm winning.
Please. Please give me, I don't even have a cup.
Yes.
Please. Please. Please get me out of here. I'm just a new show host.
Bring me some money. Somebody bring me some money.
All right, guys. Please get me out of here. I'm not meant for this life. I didn't do it. They said I did it. I didn't do it.
I did it.
I should have called Saul Goodman. I didn't. I did not do it.
Nah, you're in jail. Hey, Maria, come here.
I know I did.
Hey, this is Maria Montsma, the only girl in jail.
Only female.
What did you do?
I tore my ACL 3 times.
They sent you to jail for that?
Yeah, it's a federal crime.
Federal crime. How have you taken this into account and, like, grown as a person?
I mean, I do my community service on River Bluff Women's Soccer, so, I mean, I serve my time.
Yeah, she also runs the Women's Soccer Instagram page. So, yeah, go give that a follow. You see some sick boomerangs every morning.
RiverBluff.WomenSoccer on Instagram. River Race post, game day post.
It's awesome. It's pretty awesome. I also follow, so it's worth it. I can attest to the fact that it is worth it.
Firsthand,
yeah.
Thank
you for having me. Of course. We gotta do is sign off. All right.
Oh yeah.
Oh, you quit. Hey. You guys get better than the mic. It's clapping. It's clapping in the mic. Thank you guys. Yeah. Work hard, get smart, and do good. See you later.
Some say you can still hear those quiet claps softly echoing in the rotunda to this day. Eventually, all the students were freed from jail, and it came down to a simple choice for each of them. Either get busy living, or get busy dying.
One, two, ready, go.